हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर स्टडी अबाउट द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ह्यूमन किडनी। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द स्मॉलेस्ट स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ किडनी, दैट इज कॉल्ड यूरिनरी फेरस ट्यूब ऑफ नेफ्रॉन। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द urinary ferrous tubules are nephron, here first of all we are going to describe their structure, how a nephron looks like and what is the peculiar structure of nephron. So students, we are going to discuss about the structural and diagrammatic representation of urinary ferrous tubule. Tubules are, in short, it is known as nephron. Students, there are about more than 1 million of urinary ferrous tubules and nephrons are found in each kidney of human. The nephrons are just like to the branched structures which arises from a primary duct that is called connecting duct. This duct is called connecting duct. The connecting duct have more than thousands of urinary ferrous tubules like structures. That's why here I take a connecting duct. And these are the highly coiled structures that are called proximal convoluted tubules. The proximal convoluted tubules means the kinds of tubules which are closely related with the connecting duct. This is the ascending tube which conduct the upward direction of the filtrate that was filtered inside the urinary ferrous tubules. We know about each and every part of this urinary ferrous tubules one by one, not only diagrammatically but also what kind of function these performs. This is the descending tube of the Henle or loop of Henle. Their name is just after the name of discoverer. This is another highly coiled tube-like structure that is called the distal convoluted tubules. The end part of the distal convoluted tubules have a cup-like structure that is called Bowman's capsule. The Bowman capsule has the network of blood capillaries that allow the seepage and passes of the different part of the blood from the different part of the body that contains the nitrogenous based substances. These are the network of capillaries that contains the urinated blood, and these network of capillaries along with the renal artery and renal vein helps in the filtration of the nitrogenous based substances that are found inside the urine. The important function of these nephronic tubules is to perform the process of ultrafiltration, reabsorption, and secretion the nitrogenous waste that comes inside the blood with the afferent and efferent renal arteries. Now, students, this is the structure through which the urinated blood enters inside the bowel capsule. Now, and this is the structure through which the ultrafiltrated blood is passed out into the further artery. Now, here I join this artery with the middle part of the urinary crest tubules that is called the ascending and descending legs of the Henle loop. These are the ascending and descending part of the Henle loop through which the urinated blood get filtered, and this is the part of renal vein. It also helps in the process of ultrafiltration inside the human tube. Students, in the left half, I draw the passage of the renal artery, whereas in the right half, I illustrate the passage of the renal vein so that they can easily communicate with one another and can represent the passage of the urine from one vessel to another. Further, I will complete this diagram by connecting one another. These are the bridge elements that connects the renal artery to the renal veins, as I illustrate in the diagram. I also color the diagram so that you can clearly understand in what portion of this renal tubule the urinated blood passes out and in what section of this tubules the passage of the ultrafiltrated substances is carrying on. Here I take some colored chalk. Through which we can easily differentiate the urinated and non-urinated blood inside the renal vein and renal artery. This is the right half according to the diagram, and this is the left arm of the renal tubules. The yellow color illustrates the presence of the nitrogenous phase that is filtered inside the glomerulus part of the Bowman's capsule, and this is the light blue color that illustrate the filtered amount of the non-urinated blood. Through which the non-urinated filtered blood passes. Now here I also draw the pathway through which the filtrate passes to the different part of the nephron as substrate that contains urea, uric acid, creatinine, like the nitrogenous waste substances. Students, the presence of bilirubin in about more than 0.7% in the urine determines a disease into the patient that is recognized as the jaundice. If the bile pigment come close and the excess secretion is found out into the blood, then this makes the yellowish color to the almost whole parts of the body skin as well as each and every plasma of our body. That's why the cornea of our eyes also appears yellow in color. Now students, this is the structure of a urinary tubule, you can say that nephron. This is the collecting duct. Collecting duct. And here the collected urine is passed into the ureter through the pelvis region. I illustrate here with the red mark the passage of urine inside the collecting duct. This is afferent arteries, and this is the efferent artery. The efferent artery carries the urinated blood inside the Bowman's capsule. This is the glomerulus, and these whole structures is the juxtamedullary part of the Bowman's capsule. These are collectively called Bowman's capsule, the glomerulus and juxtamedullary part that is formed by the different capillaries of the blood. Now, this tubules is known as the distal convoluted tubules. Distal convoluted tubules. and this is the loop of inner limb, and this is the descending limb, descending limb of loop of inner limb or annular loop, and this is the ascending limb of annular loop. Ascending, this is the proximal convoluted tubules. Thus, students, what we find here? We find here the nephron or urinary tubule is consist of following three structures. What are these? The first one is distal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubules. The second one is the Henle's loop, just after the name of discover Henle's loop. And the third one is proximal convoluted tubules, proximal convoluted tubules. Students, now I am going to describe the mechanism how the filtration of the urinated blood is filtered into the Bowman's capsule, and what kind of filtrate in the form of uric acid that contains the creatinine and creatinine like substances, nitrogenous waste inside the urine is filtered inside this urinary tubule or nephron. First of all, the urinated blood is entered through the afferent artery. Afferent artery receives the urinated blood that carries from the different part of the body. Now this urinated blood passes into the glomerulus. Glomerulus is a part of the urinary tubule that has ability of the filtration, and this type of filtration is also known as ultrafiltration. Why? Because it not only filtrates the nitrogenous waste substances but also allow to filter the kinds of excess types of substances like glucose and other micromolecules, but it does not allow the filtration of the macromolecules like proteins. That's why the glomerulus act as the region of ultrafiltration. Now the filtrate is passing into the distal convoluted tubules. Distal convoluted tubules is a highly coiled tube-like structure. It is located just distance region from the connecting duct. That's why called distal convoluted tubules. The term convoluted means coiled. Distal means far away from the connecting tubes. That's why called distal convoluted tubules. The distal convoluted tubule further joined with the descending limb of annular loop, and the descending limb of annular loop has a very narrow capillary structure, just like the English alphabet U shape. This is the region where the process of reabsorption takes place. If any kind of essential substances get filter inside the glomerulus, then this is the region where these essential substances get reabsorbed and further passes into the bloodstream. That's why the hilar root is act as the reason for the mechanism of reabsorption. Further, the filtrate is passes into the proximal fermented tubule. The proximal fermented tubule is closer to the collecting duct that allows to passes the filtrate in the form of urine to the ureter. Thus, students, there are three important processes take place during the mechanism of the excretion. The first one is ultrafiltration that takes place inside the Bowman's capsule. The second one is the reabsorption that takes place in the hilar root. And the third important process of secretion that takes place by the proximal convoluted tubules that helps in collecting the urine with the help of collecting duct into the ureter. Thus, students, the important function of the nephron or uriferous tubules to detect and filtrate the nitrogenous based substances that are present in our blood, which are formed after the process of metabolic activities inside each and every cell of our body. Thus, students, this lesson is completed. If any kind of queries and comments will be observed in any topics, you can comment in the inbox, and I will also attempt to remove such kind of problems. Thanks, students, for joining today's lecture.